esportsbets.com, a unique place for true gamers. The only place to bet on esports events. You know your way around a competitive gaming scene and are willing to take a risk? Watch regular broadcasts and earn real money. Esportsbets.com. Foresight, passion, and calculation.
All right, and with that, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the show. We've got the third map, or technically the fourth map. Right now, the map score is 2-1 in favor of Fnatic. They pretty much just crushed NaVi on Inferno after having lost to them on Mirage, and they have a one-map lead, so that's how it all pans out here. Welcome to Room on Fire in the SLTV Starseries Season 10 Grand Finals, and now we're going to be on train, and this is going to be one hell of an exciting map. Semler, are you ready for it?
Oh, yes. This is perfect, Anders. This is perfect. Fnatic have just made a very clear statement to NaVi, saying, this is what we're capable of. Now, can you hang? And now we get to find out. NaVi have been put on notice. Now we get to find out if NaVi are up to snuff. If they can take this to 2-2 and go to the final map, where it's going to be a coin flip to decide their fate. But still, NaVi now are the ones who have to come back into this game in a meaningful way. I mean, man, this is so exciting, Anders.
Fnatic basically saying, remember that first half you had on Mirage? That was
cute. Yeah, right?
That was cute. Let's see what we can do here.
That was warm-up. Now the real game begins. Like, that's exactly what Fnatic said. Mirage was a warm-up, buds. Now the game begins. Now the finals start. You know, are you guys going to be able to do it? You going to take it away from us? Can you take it away from us? Like, that's, you know, Pronax. I can just picture Pronax looking over at Zeus being like, yo, come at me. Come on.
I mean, NaVi, they're the defending champions here for the SLTV Star Series. Fnatic, they did finish second at Gamescom, and it was a very, very close second as well. So they're definitely primed to try and take their victory at this LAN tournament instead. And wouldn't be at all bad if they could manage that. They were the favorites going into it. I guess there were some people who were really scared when they lost on Mirage. But then it's a best of five, and a lot can still happen. Train is going to be a highly unpredictable map as well, because it's out of the normal map rotation. All the Val tournaments have put it out, and a lot of other tournaments have sort of followed suit, our own in as well. You know, Case King of the Hill, we also put this map out because the teams, they'd rather play new maps. So that makes you wonder. I mean, both NaVi and Fnatic are decently good on train, but they can't have had, like, a lot of practice on it coming into this tournament.
No, that's very true. I mean, that's the big thing, is that Gamescom, this map is now out of the official rotation, so we don't actually know how much teams are cracking this map. I think a lot of it is going to come down to what they have done in the past, how much work they've put into it in the past. And I'm not really sure how hard Fnatic have worked on train with the new lineup. I mean, they played it, but, you know, it's a big difference going up against a team of NaVi's caliber, who have put together a lot of time into this map with this lineup. So we know what a Terror Guardian can be. We know exactly how good Zeus is at holding the inside sight. I mean, there's a lot of hurdles here for Fnatic to clear. But I think they're just going to have such terrific confidence coming out of that last map that, despite all of that, NaVi may struggle quite a bit to secure this map here.
I mean, what we saw in Inferno was a lot of engagement that was sort of pretty standard. It's not like Fnatic pulled anything really super insane out of the bank. They just did a lot of standard stuff, and it all worked out great for them. They won all the duels that they wanted to win, and if that trend continues on train, then that's all they need, pretty much. So I think it's on NaVi at this point to try and shut Fnatic down pretty early, and then, you know, get the confidence back, start playing like you have the confidence, and then, I mean, it could go either way.
What, fake it till you make it?
Exactly.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is that NaVi also have the home crowd behind them, and I'm imagining a pretty quiet stadium when NaVi were on the receiving end of that beating on Inferno. So I think they need a strong start. They need to hear the crowd behind them, and that could, you know, give them the edge going up against Fnatic. Fnatic on foreign turf are just, you know, showing that they are the beast. I mean, they are the beast of this tournament. The team that we looked at and said, okay, they've got first seed in this tournament. They're the team to beat. Well, they're showing us why. You don't take 15 rounds in a row on Mirage and then just obliterate your T half like that unless you are, you know, very clearly favorites to take this whole thing.
Yeah, I think that's what it's down to. We're missing one person from NaVi, and once he's
could
back
be GhostTV bugging out again. Sometimes it does this.
Yeah, but I think they already said they're not ready tonight, so I think we're just okay. I think we're just waiting for Starseries to get back on. There he is. And now we're good to go with the knife. And this is a pretty CT-sided map. Kind of like Nuke a little bit, and that's why this knife round could actually be pretty important for both sides.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, this is a lot... Old Fnatic lineup. I mean, this was way back in DreamHack Winter, though. They were extremely good on train. Very good on it. They came up with some very unorthodox styles that caught a lot of teams off guard. Pronax, you know, of course, at the helm of the team at the time, still is, but I don't know if Fnatic really have that same level. There's been quite a lot of time between DreamHack Winter and now, obviously. So, are Fnatic going to be able to upset here? Are they going to be able to surprise us? And more importantly, I suppose for them, surprise Na'Vi. Na'Vi, I think, are going to be very aware of what they're capable of on this map.
Oh, Edward actually leaping down and just, I don't know, manhandling Pronax. That's interesting.
No fear. No fear, only dreams. JW, though.
Batman.
Is he the dream catcher?
Well, they sort of both go for it, but it will be Seize who picks it up, and that's actually very important. I know we don't really cast knife rounds because it gets a little bit silly sometimes, but yeah, that 1-on-2 for Seize was actually critical for once.
And Edward just shouting Batman. So, okay, Na'Vi are in a good frame of mind. They've done the knife now. Next comes the huddle. Both of these teams, pretty firm believers in that. Although Starks is kind of running around right now, so I wonder if they are up or if they're kind of just taking a... might have been a very quick huddle. And Fnatic not quite moving yet, so I imagine they're still up and getting centered, getting ready for this. But both of these teams, they know there's a lot on the line right now. Na'Vi one round away from losing their title, because we have to remind all of you, if you're just tuning in and you missed the last Starseries 9, Na'Vi won it, and they didn't drop a single series the whole time. They were undefeated throughout the last Starseries 9, and that's really when they made that breakout performance to put them into like the top 8 ranking, basically, of the teams worldwide. So Na'Vi were the team to watch at Starseries 9. Again, they find themselves in the finals here, but they are a map away from losing that title to Fnatic. So, a lot on the line here for Na'Vi. They cannot lose to Fnatic back-to-back LAN events. They can't let Fnatic beat them twice.
That would certainly be painful, and maybe potentially the beginning of sort of a new rivalry within the top scene. We already have plenty of really interesting sort of matchups, and it's always nice to have more, I guess.
But we've lost El Clasico.
Yeah, we may have done that, but you know what? Something else is going to come along, don't you worry. It's going to be great.
My hat is up on the shelf, Anders. I don't know what I'm going to do with it. It's just going to sit there.
It'll find
gather dust.
With a little bit of luck, we'll just have 3 French teams that are actually even stronger than they were before. That can definitely happen, so I wouldn't be too sad.
I'm waiting. You know, I got my baguette, and I leave it out every night. You know, at my little French shrine, right, with some canned pâté and some brie, some cheese, right, a bottle of wine, that sort of stuff, right? You know, and hopefully we will have 2 French teams, 3 French teams emerge from the dust once this reshuffling happens, because there's been quite a bit of movement over there.
Yeah, I think it's going to turn out actually quite well. But obviously it's a little bit painful and always a little bit, you know, you always wonder, is it the right move to make? But I'd say in general, the French have done a pretty fine job at making roster changes. And making them work as well. And they seem to commit to them when they make them as well, right? They don't just test them out for a week and then give up.
Sure. I think the biggest shock for everybody with that entire thing is basically LDLC breaking, especially after how they decided not to break their roster when Shoxi was on the open market. They could have picked up Shoxi, but they decided, no, we're going to stick together. We're going to make this team work. And each and every tournament, they did better. They got into the semifinals of Gamescom. So I think that's the biggest shock, is just getting such big results and clearly showing progress and then breaking the team a week later. That was, I think that's what caught most people off guard.
Yeah, myself included. But sometimes there could be internal stuff, or it could just be that they had already been, you know, planning it before they went to Gamescom. They did better than they thought, but they still wanted to carry through with it. There could be a lot of stuff that we maybe don't know about.
Sure. I mean, of course, we're not going to be privy to all the information, but that's still a big surprise, I think, especially, you know, after that kind of performance. You got to be wondering a little bit. But Titan, we shall see what the new lineup is going to look like. Not sure about that article that was released on Backgound.net. That's Dalian Costanzo. He's been releasing a couple articles now, actually, about the movings and happenings over there. But basically, it's that time where, okay, we kind of think maybe this is how it's going to go, but we still have to wait and see what the official statements are going to be. So we shall see. It's going to mean a lot for the French scene and the global scene at large with how things shape up over there. But I think we are about to get into the pistol round now, not Anders.
Yes, it seems like it. So welcome to the show if you're just joining us. This is Room on Fire and the SLTV Star Series Grand Finals here in the Season 10. NaVi versus Fnatic. And right now the map score is 2-1 in favor of Fnatic. If they take one more map throughout this one or the next one, they are going to be crowned champions. But NaVi are not out of it yet. They're on the more favored side as well. And it seems like Fnatic are going for a bit of a push or at least a group up outside the B-bomb site. The question is if they're going to commit to it or fall back again. And they have plenty of time to decide.
They do. They have more than a minute left. A minute 15. That's a lifetime in CS. And for Fnatic, or for NaVi, a minute 15 is an eternity. But Fnatic love to pace themselves as well, but it does look like it's going to be the interplay after all. Seas is holding this position with the 5-7, though, and as soon as he spots this, he starts to hammer them. Great point-blank headshot there, but he gets instantly overwhelmed. Guardian from on high trying to put shots in to stop that plant from happening, but he's not going to be quick enough. And now, oh, what a shot from Guardian, though. Catches Olafmeister on the ladder, and that's going to start the train here for NaVi.
See, that was very interesting, but I do love this movement coming out from Flusher. He's got 1 point of health. He wants to be the guy wrapping around to actually finish the round, maybe in the last second or something like that. They're already down by the bomb. They've got the smoke up. They're already defusing here. NaVi, I don't think Fnatic realized they're going to have to shoot for the smoke, but it's not going to work out. And NaVi are going to come back and take the round. That's very interesting. And both teams coming up with some great moves.
All over the place, really. Just Guardian in particular, seized with one shot. One for one, that's good enough from him. But for Guardian to land that shot on Olafmeister, that was just brutal. And that really started it rolling there for NaVi, allowing them to close in because the rest of Fnatic were up in Brown Halls trying to get into positions to stop that push from happening. But Olafmeister was their point man on the bomb site in particular, or itself. So for him to go down so quickly, that threw a lot of things under the bus for Fnatic. Now they seem like they want to go for just a straight up smoke plant on A, and it's going to work. Or if not, they managed to deny it. NaVi, find the angle and stop that plant from going down.
Yeah, it looked like Pronex actually did a double take when putting on the bomb and moved up a little bit further so they could actually see him. So I'm not really sure what that was about. And that's a bit of a mistake from Fnatic's side because these smoke plants are a very popular thing on this map and something that we've seen quite often right by this barrel, which you can't really shoot through. So I'm not sure how they look like they were in position for it.
No, that was, I had already seen that plant actually going down, right? And Fnatic, okay, back-to-back plants, they're going to have plenty going into this. I mean, they still managed to get a couple kills towards the end, so they're forcing NaVi to spend some money. It's not a total loss for Fnatic, but it could have been better there. What Fnatic are going to do, though, is just straight-up all-out aggression onto this A site, trying to make use of the rifles. Pronex finally hits the headshot on Edward, but Edward takes one with him, and that's good enough right now. NaVi just need to pace themselves and manage to get the punish. Olafmeister drops the bomb in a really awkward spot, and things are not getting easier here for Fnatic.
Well, they're definitely not, but 2-on-3 is not that bad. I mean, Fnatic being on the less favored side, if they can just do some great damage every round, that's definitely going to be worth a lot. Flusher almost catching the opening kill. He's got a lot of time to work with here, and the more kills he gets right here, the better, but it's not going to be happening. Guardian will take him down, and that is, after all, a pretty good round from NaVi, right? They survive with three members.
Yeah, and I'm wondering at what point Guardian is going to pick up an AWP. If he drops this AK and goes for it now, he has the money. Guardian. 4750.
He's going to be having a pistol. He realized they're ecoing. They didn't put down the bomb, so he can be pretty sure. So he just wants to save as much as he can.
Okay, then.
And Edward with some great headshots on Flusher and Crims outside. Gonna go for a third headshot. Actually, he just sprays down Cronax. And JW goes down. Still no bomb plant happening for Fnatic. NaVi locking it down in these anti-ecos, and that's good news for them. And there's the AWP. Now he guesses that they're probably going to be buying, so he's ready for it.
Yeah, this makes sense. Fifth round buy coming out here from Fnatic. A lot of this actually going pretty well, according to plan, basically, for NaVi. They've won the pistol round. They won that first hurdle, the buy round in the fourth. Or rather in the third, now Fnatic in the fifth, full buy from them, and not only that, a double AWP play from Fnatic. This is not something we see very often, especially T-side train.
Oh,
what a shot from JW.
Did he just do that? He just leapt down the ladder and then got a kill and fell back up again. That's ridiculous. Guardian up here is going to go down to Olafmeister. And, well, they've lost JW, but this is still a really big opening for Fnatic here.
Oh, that was fantastic, and that was artwork there at the end of... At the end of Ivy, I think it was Pronax, basically. He peeked out, showed his gun barrel to Guardian, and Olafmeister peeks immediately after that. Guardian can't react in time for the shot. So just such teamwork coming out from Fnatic right now. They are really displaying something here, and this is a round where they really have a solid shot at getting out onto the site. Crims peeks right, he peeks left, and Edward is waiting with the AWP to shut him down, brings it back to a 3-on-3, and Fnatic still have to get out onto this site somehow. Pronax gets legged over an Ivy. That's not going to help things. Stark's going to chase them around, and 40 seconds left. Fnatic, they need to get control of this site.
Yeah, they definitely do. Killing Starks is a good start here, but Seized with the return still. No bomb plant, and Olofmeister's now going to be alone. 1-on-2, he's going to go for the plant at least, but as he does, they creep very close, and they're going to be able to take him down. But they got the bomb plant, so they can buy in the next round, but that's a bit of a shame. That was a very good position for Fnatic, and they couldn't close it out.
And even with three guys living at the end here for Na'Vi, or rather, two guys living, they'll be able to hold on to that AWP, the all-important AWP for Guardian. The money is still there for Na'Vi. That's the big thing here. C is still sitting on 9k. Fnatic, they are able to go for a pretty healthy buy, but as we can see, Flusha could have bought an AWP. Wolfmeister could have as well bought a glass cannon AWP, but there is no AWP picked up for Fnatic. They want to rely on mobility right now. And is it going to be a pop rush? No. Are they going for a fake into upper halls? The bomb is all the way over at Alley right now. What are Fnatic doing?
It's a risky fake, but it can be done. I mean, Train's definitely a map that allows for a lot of this kind of stuff, and Olofmeister goes down. Great opening, but instant return from Flusher is going to put Fnatic right back in the game. Guardian missing a shot at the upside of the B-bomb site.
Yeah, smokes and flashes going down, however, onto this inner site, and JW is just going to push through straight to connector. The bomb is now caught up, but this has bought time for Na'Vi to make a rotation. Edward is now here to support Guardian, and Fnatic do not have control of this site yet.
And because they already checked where Edward is and he moved in after they sort of went into the bomb site, they just have no idea. So they're going to be going down 1 and 2. Flusher jumping in. JW very close to the connector here. Might be able to get an early kill on somebody. And he's going to be alone. Actually, Flusher will go down, and that's going to be the end of the round. I think Edward made that round. Just moving up after they had already gone down the sidewalk. That was very smart.
That was really nicely done. And just good play there by Na'Vi covering the ground. When it came down to it, Guardian and Edward getting up close like that. Not sure if Fnatic expected it to be that quick, and I think you're right. Edward managing to get a perfect angle, basically, to catch Fnatic off guard as they come rushing out onto the site. Because you can probably be sure that in Fnatic's mind, they're thinking that Na'Vi aren't going to fully commit. Okay, Guardian is on upper, but the second guy coming into support is probably going to be somewhere around connector. He's not going to be right there on the site holding so aggressively around the corner.
That actually puts Fnatic back on an eco. This is not good. I mean, we're very likely going to be looking at a 7-0 start here, which doesn't mean Fnatic are out of this map by any means, but it is a little bit worrying because we just saw Fnatic stomp Ma'Vi on Inferno. That was 16-3, and they really don't want to have the opposite thing happening to them.
Well, I mean, we do. I mean, it's like, okay, right? No, but then we get our final map, Anders.
That's true.
So, like, are we not entertained, right? We go the distance, we get everything we want.
Yeah, that's a good point. I'll stick to that. We do want to see a third map. Double up setup for Fnatic once again. I think it's a very cool choice. I mean, there's so many openings, and they have JW and Olofmeister both, so why not use them?
Yeah, and a lot of this is coming down to individual play right now for Fnatic. I mean, they're going to be basically relying on the big shots, the big aim. Zeus is once again close up to connector. JW goes jumping down, but this time he's a little bit too early, and Zeus gets the drop on him. Zeus not used. Points his finger, JW is gone. Olofmeister is waiting up there, but Zeus is not about to throw away this advantage. He does not need to go taking any kind of risk going up that ladder. Just hold back and play the angle.
Grenade out, tags Guardian a tiny bit all the way over by Ivy, but... Oh, it's a nice pickup from Flusher. Takes down Seized, and yeah, those return frags have actually been pretty good for Fnatic. I feel like most of the time when they lose a man early on, they just bounce right back into it. And Edward, is he really at 15-2-2? That's pretty absurd.
Whoa, I hadn't even noticed yet. Good point. Edward is having a hell of a game right now, and he's also in a pretty snazzy spot. It does look like Fnatic are going to go for A, but had they gone for B, Edward could have outflanked the whole lot of them right there. Playing down top, though, the bomb is slowly moving, and Pronax is waiting for this smoke to clear to start putting pressure on back alley and the back line where Guardian and Starks are currently holding for Na'Vi. That this is a crucial position for Pronax. If he can find a quick frag here, that really forces the rotation out of Na'Vi. Although Zeus is on a mission, and he's in the back lines, he's behind Fnatic, and he's gonna flank Flusha.
Yeah, and that's a big problem here. Now, finally, Edward's position comes into play and almost gets a kill here, leaving all of Meister on 1 point of health, and that's going to be a cleanup. And even worse, I think, for Fnatic this time, because as they were creeping around looking for a way to get into a bomb site, they actually just got completely picked apart and even backstabbed, and that's mentally going forward a big issue. And now Seize has even picked up an auto sniper. NaVi are really serious about this.
Oh, this is, yeah, well, this is just a return, and this is what I was worried about going into this map. We're not really seeing anything refined come up from Fnatic. No smoke rounds, no flashes. I mean, they're going for very basic sorts of plays that revolve around picks. And NaVi are too good on train for that to work. They have too much experience with this lineup on this map for a very simple style like that to work. It's just going to be, it's going to keep being Fnatic running into a blender, basically, unless they can land key shots like that. Pronex, with a great headshot on Starks, gives Fnatic a man lead, and they actually get a bomb plant.
Yeah, and they have time to get into great positions as well, so as long as they stay hidden and don't show themselves, they should be working out great here. Olofmeister does go down, and then equalizes it to a 3-on-3. JW controls the spray, and Seuss not going to pick up the kill, so great work from Fnatic. Finally, it's going to be a 2-on-2, but that bomb is already pretty far ticked. And NaVi, they need to get in here and start defusing already. There's going to be a Molotov out. Now, Seize is already on it. Can they stop him? No, they cannot stop him. Krims goes down, and NaVi retake it 4-on-3. And my god, that's got to be soul-destroying for Fnatic here. 9-0 is the scoreline, and Krims has actually not picked up a kill yet in these first 9 rounds. And considering how massive he was on Inferno, that's got to be frustrating him on a personal level too.
On Inferno, on Mirage, on the whole lot. But, you know, not only is it Edward, but Guardian just, I mean, that frag on Pronax, dropping him before he could deny the defuse, that was just amazing. That's what saved that round right there for NaVi. So Guardian coming in big, and he's been doing it time and time again, all tournament long, for NaVi. Guardian has been their point man, their key clutcher. And now Fnatic, they have to go for a B play, it seems. I mean, they're going to try and just rush down lower. They've got the bomb behind them. The train has begun, and they do catch NaVi out of position, so they will actually get onto this bomb site.
Seized goes down, a Guardian from the back end, dropping Pronax and the bomb, and a grenade to follow actually will do great damage here. Olofmeister on 1 point of health from that Guardian grenade. The magic apple, as he sometimes likes to call it. And Krims looking under the train is going to challenge and take down Guardian. That's great, Krims. We need you back in the game right here if Fnatic want a chance. And he at least picks up the first kill of the game for himself. And that's a 3-on-3 with the bomb down. And Fnatic, again, with a good chance of doing it.
Yep, Starx catching JW off guard, however, on upper. That's going to open things up. Olofmeister only the 1 point of health, and he's instantly given by Starx. Zeus has walked onto the site and picked off Flusha, and there's ample time for the defuse. Two kits here for NaVi, and they will get it with plenty of time, even saving the AWP for Guardian. Zeus has that SCAR 20, and NaVi have now got 10 rounds on the board. We're quickly approaching the point where Fnatic are running out of rounds to give away. Like, they need at least 4 rounds, at least 4 rounds, I'd say, on their T side of train to have a shot at it. in the next half.
No, I definitely agree, and I look at the madness that NaVi are bringing to the table here. There are 2 AWPs and an auto sniper, so they want to keep Fnatic guessing, and they also just maybe want to brag about how much money they have. It's going to be so tough. Good opening from Flusha, though. Takes down Seuss.
This is a big investment, but when there's so many guys who have over $10,000 on NaVi, it's not the end of the world. JW will get 2 great frags. Flusha and him really opening things up here for Fnatic on this A site, but there's still 2 guys alive for NaVi, alive at the back line, but it's a 2-on-4, and they just don't have the weapons necessary for a retake here. They have a SCAR 20 and an AWP. SCAR 20, okay, maybe, but an AWP is not the best rifle to be using when you're trying to get back onto a bomb site.
No, definitely not. Seize will pick up 1 kill, but they really should be walking away from this. I don't see any reason why they keep pressing the issue here. And they are going to go down. Fnatic going to pick up the first round of this map for themselves. 10-1. Still plenty of money for NaVi, and that's obviously part of the problem here.
Well, you can understand, if they get another kill there, Fnatic, the damage done is going to be such that they will not have much money in the bank. Right now they have 2 guys who have reasonable dough with 1450 on Olaf. But imagine one more guy gets caught there. That's, you know, Fnatic towing the line right now. NaVi, if they win this round right here, Fnatic are back in the Stone Age regarding money. And I think that's what NaVi are about. They're like, we have so much money, we can throw away these guns. It's not a problem for us. You guys are the ones who can't afford to be spending money in the next round if you win it. So now we see, do NaVi manage to shut it down? Zeus taking a good bit of damage there from Krims to start. Nicely done there by Krims. And Fnatic going with a very standard 2-on-2 setup right now on their T side, just spreading out across the map looking for a pick.
Already taking a little bit of damage. A lot of Molotovs on Navi's side too to try and prevent the bomb plant or just zone somebody out in the retake. Really good. I think Molotovs on train are just so valuable. So I'm glad to see Navi picking so many of them up. The one thing Fnatic really can't afford is to lose a round right about now because, you know, they've just reset their loss bonus. So they got
to
keep chaining.
Yeah, they're back to 1400.
Yeah, they got to keep chaining.
That's the scary part. But Fnatic, if ever they were going to have a chance, now's the time. Four rounds left in this half. If they could put two together right here, that kind of starts the momentum train going their way. So Na'Vi, 35 seconds left on this clock. Na'Vi still solid with the defense. Two guys on inner sight, three guys on outer sight. And Na'Vi, they're going to have to hit some big shots. And JW, speaking of big shots, catches Edward coming out of Pop Dog. And that's a great opportunity here for Fnatic to speed up.
That's the opening they were looking for. Seuss is going to take down Pronax, though, so that's half the flank sort of already gone. And there's the Olofmeister coming into play. Great double for him. And now Guardian is going to go down as well, so Fnatic will pick up a second round here. Seized may have been playing well, but he's not going to be able to do this 1-on-4.
No, I'd actually like to see him back off at this point. Like, last round, okay, economic damage, great. But this round, now the money is starting to get a little weird for Na'Vi. They've got two guys who have got really good bank, two other guys who are kind of floating so-so, and then Seized himself, who has $450 to his name. So actually, if he holds onto this gun, that'd be really good for the next round. But he's looking to see if he can't pick somebody off here. Krim's about to walk right back into him. Knife and...
What?
There we go. But that took way too long. Now he's going to get cut off. JW is watching down the alley and manages to land the op shot. No misses there. Seized with an uncharacteristic spray and pray play there, and that did not work.
Yeah, that actually looked a little bit funny, didn't it?
I like the simultaneous jinx from us, man. Like, but I think we're both equally shocked. We're both equally shocked. Like, that's a shot that you just don't miss from Seize. That's like an instant headshot right there. It's a freebie.
Now the problem is there's three people in the next round. If Na'Vi lose this round, three of them can buy in the next round, but two of them can't. So they really need to start getting back in where they were. Otherwise, Fnatic could still have a great first half. And look at Flush opening up. Gonna get the quick double here. Returned on by Seuss, taking down JW as well. And Starix got a kill on Olofmeister. So it does sort of equalize. But Flush with a terrifying opening here. Starix gonna drop Pronax.
And he drops the bomb at his feet as well. Now this is perfect. They know exactly where Krims is. Krims putting out a shot, making it clear. But Seized has already cut him off. This is the thing. Oh, Seized, don't pull out a nade. Just land the shot. Moment's hesitation there by Seized. Goes for the HE, but keeps the rifle out and gets the kill in the end. And now we see Na'Vi. Well, Na'Vi stabilize. Fnatic, because of that last round, they've actually got a pretty good bank going into this, into the before last. But they have to make a decision now. If they invest everything in this round and lose, then they aren't going to have much bank going into the last one. But I think they have enough to be able to stretch here.
Yeah, they do. They do manage. It's going to be a Galil on Pronax because they went for an AW here. I think that's a solid choice instead of having, you know, two Galils. But rather have one AW here or maybe an AK and a Galil or something like that. I do appreciate the fact that they gave Krim sort of a Viking burial over at the A-bomb site. They actually Molotov'd him while he was dead, so he's going to be with his ancestors somewhere.
Drinking mead.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, I do like that they give AWP the JWP basically, because he's been getting some good frags for Fnatic in the last couple of rounds with that sniper rifle. And there you go. He already tags Edward from Pop Dog. Edward has to move, change up the position, but he's down to 17 HP. So they know, Na'Vi know now, okay, well, Fnatic have an AWP. We have to be worried here a little bit. Guardian is now looking for a forward position, the old get right spot basically, in inner, but he's not going to have a target right now.
Flash goes in, and Guardian will take JW. He wanted to switch his position and try and see if he can get another opening at the B bomb side after having already softened up Edward, but it doesn't go out that way. Starix is going to pick up a kill here. Krims comes in with a good headshot, but is it going to be too late?
Oh, Krims comes so close to taking out Seuss. Nearly nails the pre-fire shot, but he's going to get caught in the end, and now the man advantage goes back Navi's way. Fnatic do get the plant, and Seized his cotton connector. Flash is completely white, he can't get a shot in, and now Fnatic stabilized somewhat. Smoke is about to clear, and Seize spots Pronax through, and this is going to be a quick one-for-one trade. It's all down to Flusher, he's got the AWP, but he can't land a shot, and Seize will win the day in the end for Na'Vi. And that was a round that Fnatic could ill afford to lose. It's going to be a force now with all of them floating around $3,000.
Could very likely be a 13-2 finish here for the first half. Which still would not put Fnatic out of the game, but it would, or out of the map at least, but it would certainly necessitate them winning the piss around on the second half. And that's, you know, that's a lot to gamble on, because, you know, Na'Vi are still they're playing a really good train map, basically. They're not making many mistakes.
No, they're doing a fantastic job. And this is, I think this is a lot of experience, basically, for Na'Vi on this map, whereas Fnatic are definitely relying more on their aim, more on their ability to get frags. But it's going to be the full-out YOLO. Olafmeister just goes running into Zeus, swaps to the gun, but couldn't have worse timing. Guardian going to miss a point-blank shot. But it's still a 3-on-1 situation. Fnatic in the last round, standing near ground. Flasha doing his best, but he will get caught. And that is going to be a 13-2 finish here. Na'Vi, it's Mirage all over again, is it not?
It feels like it. I mean, on Mirage, which is actually a less CT-sided map than Train is, Fnatic did make the comeback. So you have to keep that in mind before you start panicking too much about your precious skins. But obviously, you know, if Na'Vi win the pistol round, that pretty much seals the deal. I don't see any way that Fnatic are going to be bringing it back after that. But pistol round win, they can totally, you know, they can even win, but they could at least also force the overtime. I would not rule that out.
Neither could. I mean, exactly. I'm not calling anything until one of these two teams has 16 rounds on the board, or 19 rounds, whichever way it goes. Guys, Fnatic could definitely come back in this with the CT side. Of course, a lot of that is going to depend on the aim once again, but also on the communication. That's the other thing that makes it so difficult to deal with Na'Vi, is because they just have so much experience on the CT side of Train. They have it all mapped out. So will Fnatic be able to have that same level when they switch over to the defense? Are they going to know how their rotations are going to work? Are they going to know who's going to be covering which angle at which time? This sort of information is what you build up the more and more you play a map. So Fnatic, with the new lineup that you know is Olafmeister and Krims being added into the core group of Flusha, JW, and Pronax, do they have that experience? I don't think so.
I think, well, maybe not, but I think Na'Vi likewise are not going to be that schooled on the terrorist side still. I mean, it's probably been a while since they played it. I think if Fnatic win the pistol round, I think they're gonna be sort of back on track. Doesn't mean they'll win it all the way, because Na'Vi, I mean, Train is a map where you can really get entry frags. A lot more on a lot of other maps, you know. Like, Inferno can be really hard to get an entry frag without losing at least one player. On Train, I'd say it's a lot easier, because you just have to, like, you know, peek out with an AK, get a first shot, and that's it.
Are they going to go for it? They decide to back off. Are they going to hesitate? I thought that they were going to go for the straight up, and already instant rotation from Fnatic. They put three guys on that inner site in the blink of an eye. But there is still Starx waiting, lurking over by Alley, making sure that nobody can push out. And now Na'Vi play a bit more of the Na'Vi style here. They make a whole lot of noise. It was like a herd of bison stampeding through those halls towards that B site. And you could see Fnatic instantly rotate an extra two guys over to help cover. And now Na'Vi, once that fake has gone, has not really panned out for them, they just go back to holding across the map, looking for the picks and the information.
Fnatic, on the other hand, are doing a good job of not getting too rattled. I mean, they did rotate one guy into B, but that's generally pretty common, having the first couple of seconds, everyone, except for one guy, like four people in the A-bomb site, and then after a while, rotating one back to B. So I think that's all Fnatic have done. Right now, they're waiting for Na'Vi.
Oh, Crims. Oh, Seized is going to find the first shot. Crims with the double line in Alley. He manages to whip around, pull 90 degrees, and still stay alive. JW with a great click, but he's going to go ahead and face down two guns. It's the Crims. JW crossfire, and Crims gets three. JW gets two. But that could not have gone better for Fnatic. What a fantastic position for Crims to find himself in at the beginning when the push was coming in through Alley. That was two clicks, two headshots. He couldn't have asked for a better start.
Yeah, great comeback from Crims. I mean, we were sort of highlighting him earlier on in the first half when he had played the first six or seven rounds without killing anyone, and now he's actually back and sort of in the middle of the scoreboard frag-wise, so that's a really good job, and I really expect nothing else from Crims. He's a pro player, and he's one of the best, so, but it's nice to see that he's sort of mentally staying composed and not losing himself, because, you know, obviously the team as a whole can give up, and there could be, like, a feeling of mental breakdown amongst the whole team, but even if one person decides, I just can't do it today, that's a huge issue.
Na'Vi are going for the straight up YOLO rush out onto B right now. The whole strategy behind this play is to get the plant as quickly as possible, but Flush with the MP7 gets a quad kill.
Wow.
That's $2,400 in his pocket, $600 a frag, which is the whole reason why you go for an SMG like that. Just look at his money compared to the rest of his team. Four kills with that gun is brutal. He turns into the Bank of Sweden in one round, basically. But one point that you need to make, Anders, is basically that Crims on LGB never really got the opportunity to shine, because he was overshadowed by other players like Dennis, you know, soi-disant star players, right? Dennis, Olafmeister, even Huyten and Michael Lele. you know, were really stepping up and getting big kills. And Crimson was always kind of like, you know, he had his moments, but he was never really able to get to the forefront, right? Here on Fnatic, clearly they're like, Crims, you're our point man. Go to work. Go get the frags. And he's really shown that he's capable of stepping up.
Yeah, and, you know, that's an interesting sort of experiment. Just, you know, a lot can happen if you take a player from one, you know, sort of position and put them in a different one. They can play very differently. So Crims definitely has adjusted quite nicely. Flusher wants more eco-frags here with the MP7. He's going to pick up two and goes for a third one. Actually going to be the pistol out. He'll eventually go down, but he still netted himself a lot of money in just two rounds here. He's up to 5,500.
Yeah, and now he's at $8,750. That's a lot of money to have this early on. A lot of bank. He could give an AWP over to JW right now. Although it seems like JW doesn't want to. JW buys an M4 and Flusher will get dropped. Flusher will get dropped to FAMAS, and it's going to be Olafmeister who buys himself an AWP. Okay, so Fnatic just kind of playing around with their money right now. It looks like they just want to keep that big bank on Flusher. Used to teams seeing it or spreading it out a bit more, but maybe Pronax, he wants to have one guy with just a large sum in the back in case they have to go for an op play of some sort. Or a double rifle drop.
Sharing is not caring if you're Flusher. Doesn't believe in that.
Well, I mean, clearly, look at all the frags he got. It's all about padding the stats with Flusher.
17-1 and 14, it's not bad at all. Tied with Edward on the other team, who's also got 17 kills. But right now, NaVi need to decide if they want to put Fnatic back on their perform in the first half and just win this game outright. You know, win it something like 16-8 or something. Just, you know, take a couple of rounds to build something together and then make it work. Or if they're going to allow Fnatic the momentum and the confidence to build a real comeback here.
We saw it happen on Mirage. That's the thing. NaVi have got to be having like flashbacks right now. If they lose this next round, this is the first big round here for NaVi. 19th round, the bye round. If they lose this, NaVi are going to be having flashbacks to Mirage, and that's not a very comfortable feeling for them. But they do manage to get the bomb plant down on the B site. Only problem is that Fnatic still have the man advantage, and they still have time to act. Olafmeister trying to find an angle to work, but Flusher is going to get a double spray down. Zeus and Starks both gone. Olafmeister gets the shot from on high, and Fnatic will live. All four members survive to see through the round.
And this brings us to one of the finer points of the B-bomb side of train here, just to highlight this issue that NaVi just faced, which is that it's great getting in and getting a bomb down, but it's actually not that difficult because you can flash and smoke off the people that are holding close. The problem is that as long as you're stuck in this area here, it's not really that great. You want to be able to either get up to the high ground, or even better, I think, is trying to get some people close to where the CTs actually enter so that the fight sort of happens away from the bomb site, and you can turn it into like a 2-on-2 or a 1-on-1, and then you can have the guy on the high ground really coming into play. But NaVi, they got bogged down inside that bomb site, and that's kind of a no-no.
No, that is a bit of a no-no, and I think they all got some boo-boos too, so... NaVi now really have to figure out a way to start getting a little bit of momentum away from Fnatic, and getting the entry frag is a good start here. Pronax already picked off. Pronax not having a huge impact so far in these rounds though for Fnatic, only sitting on 5 or 6 frags, so it's not a big loss for Fnatic. Getting Flusher or Krims would have been a much bigger blow dealt to the defense. Still, NaVi have that man advantage now, so they will be able to build off of this. The question is it going to be the B play after all? Because the bomb is slowly migrating over here, and now we have Starks making his way through Whitehalls as well. It looks like NaVi want to shape up for an interplay once again.
Well, they do. Still a long distance. Fnatic need to win 10 rounds in a row here if they want to win the map. And if they allow NaVi to get back into it sort of right away, then it could finish a lot earlier than that. 10 rounds on train? It could be done.
Oh, certainly. Easier than on Mirage.
Oh, look at this move from JW. He turns around 180 and takes down Starix. That was, I think, like a 1 in 1,000 move from JW. Very cool play there. Just using the smoke that they had put down against them. They were not ready for that. Guardian does get a shot on Olafmeister, but he doesn't quite go down. But the bomb is planted. It's another 3-on-3 coming in here. Flusher is going to be falling, and now it's a 2-on-2. But I'm not sure Fnatic can win this round.
Edward is in a pretty advantageous position up on CT Sniper like this. He's going to manage to get the flank on Crims as well. Perfect execution. Guardian really locking down that site, though, for his team. Getting three frags. Holding from all the way in back with that AWP. Basically pinning down Olafmeister at the start so that Olaf couldn't really do anything at all for Fnatic. And then making sure that whoever was coming in through connector, whoever tried to walk in from the back line, just wouldn't be able to get anything done. So NaVi now. NaVi, they pick up one round on the T side. They need two more. And yeah. Are these going to be the hardest, like, are these going to be the toughest two rounds of Navi's life? And this is what we're about to find out. They forget the bomb, and the bomb is kind of crucial. It's kind of an important thing here.
Yeah, I mean, unless you're trying something brand new and undiscovered, generally carrying the bomb around is a good idea.
How you kill the entire team.
Yeah, just ignore it. Turn it into a deathmatch.
Oh, nice double nade, though, down on Navi at Alley. That was a lot of damage dealt. That's still information gained, but I mean, it's not so uncommon to have two guys holding it at Alley like this, so NaVi can't really look into it too much. But they still have the bomb at T-Main, they have a man waiting around Pop Dog, and then three guys at Alley. NaVi are looking for an A play here. They're really looking to just kind of crush in on Fnatic, and this Alley here is going to be the key point for this take.
Now let's see. 40 seconds is, in NaVi terms, pretty a long time to deal with. So they're still just making up their minds, but it feels like it's eventually going to be like a 3-1-1 push. Three people coming Ivy, one into main and one through Popdog. And that can work really well, but they do need the entry frags on at least sort of one or two of these places. If they all just go down, that's not good enough here. Pronax being forced back around the corner, and Seuss will open up.
Great entry there, JW and Popdog. He's about to get dropped down on, but the timing from Edward just does not work out. Flush a Fnatic, Flush a JW and Olafmeister all getting frags, and then Guardian gets one of the sickest double headshots we've ever seen. He's going to manage to get onto this side as well with 5 seconds left. Goes for the plant, but he's not going to be allowed to finish it. Flush denies him at the very last second, but Fnatic, they breathe a sigh of relief. Guardian, the double shot, headshot, and then the other one as well. I hope you caught that on camera. Did you catch that on camera?
Yeah, I believe we caught most of it. That was really frightening. I mean, just that kind of action is what Fnatic need, because if they lose another round, I mean, they've lost so many people in the last couple of rounds. If they actually lose a round now, it's almost like NaVi can actually close out the game, just because at least two of the members on Fnatic won't have that great equipment. But on the other hand, NaVi are ecoing, and they're running into this Molotov by Flusher.
Starx is going to manage to get up on this site, and there isn't much Flusher can do about it to stop it. He's going to be able to pick up some frags, but that bomb will get planted for NaVi. One kill going in for NaVi as well. Olafmeister just holding down Mouse 1, getting a bit greedy there. His teammates will come in to save the day and save that AWP, more importantly, but Olafmeister could have restrained himself a little bit and lived through that encounter.
Oh, man. 14-8. If they just get another 8 rounds, if they double their round score right now, then they're home free, and that would be kind of a sick ending to a grand finals if Fnatic were able to make this kind of comeback. They already did it almost once on Mirage, so I don't know. It seems like Counter-Strike has sort of evolved into a place where comebacks are a little bit more possible, perhaps.
Oh, absolutely. Well, it's also, I think, depending on the teams, and it seems like Fnatic CT side, when they are able to just set up the defense and try and land the shots, they're doing a really good job of it. Nade on the Pronax, not going to do too much. Starks looking to get the follow-up shot, however, and Pronax just barely dancing on the edge. Avoids the damage for now, and deals it right back to Starks. About maximum damage dealt there. That was very close. That was very nicely done there by Pronax.
That's very cool. And Popdog is going to be JW getting a kill on Edward, so that was one of the things that should have worked. I mean, last time we saw the 3-1-1, this time it's sort of a 1-3-1, so they actually put three people in the middle trying to see if that works up. And it does make a difference in the end, but it all still depends on the entry frags, which right now Fnatic are getting more of.
Yeah, Pronax giving himself up there. Olafmeister, however, is going to manage to pick off Zeus, who is in connector. Guardian is going to get caught point blank. Crims takes him out, but now it's a 1-on-2. Starks is coming out of the back line. He needs to get this kill on Olafmeister quick. He doesn't have eyes on the bomb either, but Fnatic, rather than challenge, they're letting him sweat. There's 30 seconds left on this clock, and Starks would just love to land one shot here. If he could find the way to turn this into a 1v1, this would be great. Does he predict where Flush is coming from for the flank, however?
He was thinking about it. I was wondering if he even wanted to go for the B bomb site right now. He's got 19 seconds. He got to move really quickly, and Olafmeister sees it coming, so the positions for Fnatic were just actually great. They wanted to make sure that if he wanted to put the bomb down, they could go and retake it 2-on-1 instead. And if he tried to sneak out, then they'd have him boxed in.
Yeah, that's 3 rounds in a row now for Fnatic after Na'Vi's 1-round win there. So they aren't quite to the point where they're going to be able to buy regardless of a drop or not, or a bomb plant rather, or not. So Na'Vi just going for another round of eco here. Imagine, I can't see why they would even change up. Why not just go for a straight up YOLO B play again and just get that bomb plant down? They're going to spread out instead. Zeus eating a lot of nade damage to start.
But the interesting thing is, it seems like this A push from Na'Vi is actually working quite well, right? They all of the time, they get themselves into this, you know, 2-on-2, 1-on-2 situation. And that's great. Eventually, there's a good chance that Na'Vi can win. And they have the rounds to play with. So I don't really blame Na'Vi for continuously trying to do it. It's going to be scary for Fnatic, because if they keep having to play the next, you know, 7 rounds in a row, and all of the time it's down to you know, 1-on-1, 1-on-2, that's really, that's frightening.
That's nerve-wracking. We're going to have to check Olaf Munster for gray hair afterwards. I mean, he's going to age 15 years.
Yeah, pretty much.
I'm waiting to see if Na'Vi are going to go for like a big smoke round or something along those lines. Because I feel like a lot of the play that we've seen has revolved quite a bit around the aim duels again. And Fnatic are barely hanging on through those, so we'll see what Na'Vi decide to do in the next round. Edward is kind of on a solo mission right now. It's a 1-on-5 situation. Likelihood of him coming through is actually not that great, and Krim spots him through that smoke. Lands the shot, the first one, and now we get to see exactly what Na'Vi are going to bring to the fore here. Because they should have ample money, plenty of money to go for a buy, to get all the nades, to get all the rifles, all the guns. What do they do, though? Do they spread out, or do they try and set something up?
I wouldn't be surprised if they're just going to go for the A push again, because it feels like they can get into the B bomb site and get the bomb down, but their hold on it is somehow much worse. So I wouldn't be surprised if we're going to see something similar again. This time, are they going to smoke in from the outside? Because that's actually something they haven't done so much before. They've just, you know, they've gone to the entrances and then thrown grenades from there, kind of like Zeus is doing here. But this time, Starix in this position is kind of a big tell, and also up here. So yeah, they're going to go for some coordinated smokes and then a push.
Yeah. And Zeus is going to be taking point on this. Curious if Edward is going to make any noise towards that inner site, just to make sure that those two guys who are holding right now are going to stay there. Guardian taking a frightful amount of damage over in Popdog, though. Good play there by JW to hunt him back. Krims is holding towards Team Main, and the defense is solid right now for Fnatic, but there is still two guys over here for Fnatic on the base site. If Na'Vi decide to go for this play towards A, this could be very good for them.
Yeah, they're certainly coming, so that's a great entry frag into the bomb site.
Yeah, but look at this. Look at Na'Vi. They see it coming. They're going to let Starx kind of go to town, try and act as if there's everybody here from Na'Vi, but they already have an inkling. Olafmeister's making his way towards the B site, but it's a second too late. Guardian manages to cut him off. Starx with the frag on A as well. This is falling apart for Fnatic. They're into a 2-on-4, and they aren't going to be able to stop this bomb from getting planted. Edward, all the way back in CT spawn, goes for the spray and manages to pick up Pronax.
This is a big round, and it's really well thought out. It was well calculated by Na'Vi, because, as we've been pointing out, they've been going for this A bomb site for like 3 or 4 rounds in a row and almost bringing it close. So in the 5th round, they decide, okay, we're going to throw smokes and flashbangs like we're going, and then, as you said, just let Starix run out there, and then hopefully Fnatic are going to remember the last 4 rounds and think it's going to be another goddamn A push, but it wasn't.
It wasn't, and that's the magic of the mines right now. Na'Vi, they make the right call, and Zeus definitely coming through when it mattered most. Now they're on that 15th round, but now, do we see Fnatic run it back again? Is this mirage happening all over again, or do Na'Vi actually close it out? They have all the money, everything they need right here to get the job done. All the smokes, all the nades, and Guardian has got Kevlar this time, so if he decides to take the fight with JW, it's not going to be so risky, but instead what they're going to do is a bit of an Olafmeister, in fact. I'm wondering if they're going to boost Guardian up on the fence back here to make sure that that he can get the high ground advantage going into this duel.
Well, look at where Pronax is standing. Pronax is just like, he has a knack for finding these weird corners. This is kind of like what he does on Mirage up in the apartments, right? Just standing on a tiny ledge, and now he's going to be moving forward because he heard them running back. If he can come up with a kill here, that would be huge. Na'Vi is setting up for a push, but Guardian is actually looking the right way. Pronax, he could get picked off, and that would be the worst opening. He is going to get picked off, seized as well. I'm wondering if that was a straight fake from Na'Vi, if they actually ran down there in order to just run back and hope that someone was going to push behind them.
They were holding. I mean, that's the thing. They made sure that they were in a position to deal with it if it happened. And so, not sure if that was premeditated or not. It looked like it with all those guys watching back there. But NaVi now with a golden opportunity. They got the entry. They have the advantage. JW sprays up a Guardian and somehow doesn't get the frag either. So now they maintain that advantage. NaVi, 35 seconds on the clock. They have to make a go of it here. And are they going to make the right call as to which site? The bomb is making its way through White Halls towards B site. It seems like this is going to be the play here. NaVi, 25 seconds left. Need to get out here somehow.
Starix goes down. Guardian is in a good position to pick up anyone coming in, and he's going to kill Flusher. But up from behind, and this could be the big move, is JW. He's going to look for Guardian and takes him down right through the box. So it's a 3-on-3. Comes up, takes down Seuss as well. And Edward, well, the bomb is down. He's going to have to get this kill on Crims pretty quickly, and he won't be able to. Crims takes him down, and it's 15-10.
And with plenty of time 15, to defuse. 11. Yeah, it's going to be 15-11 now. Crims saves the AWP as well for Olofmeister or JW, whichever one. JW plays the position under Pop Dog, though, so I guess you understand why he doesn't want that AWP per se, because essentially, you know, what's he going to do with it that close? Olofmeister is going to be the man holding on to it, and JW is going to stick with the M4A1, or with the AK rather. But still, Fnatic actually managing to recover fairly well there. NaVi, I thought they would actually have the advantage, but the defense on the site there, Edward was just a second too late to pick up Crims, and that's, I think, the big thing. He managed to find Olofmeister fairly quickly at connector, but Crims gets by and just shuts down the defense on the actual site. And when it comes down to it, Edward just can't not stop him.
Oh, Flusher getting overpowered, and now there's only one guy holding, and it is Olofmeister, so it's not the worst person. Oh my god, he's going to pick up Seuss as well. And JW's there to help him out with Edwards, so that looked like it was going to be the opening for NaVi, but then Olofmeister just shuts it down.
Oh, and Guardian with a sick flick shot right there onto Pronax towards CT again. But that bomb is now dropped on that site, and Starix is on a mission. He's looking to get the flank right now, and are they going to be wondering about this? Crims is already looking towards A site from connector. He's going to catch Starix. As soon as Starix rounds this corner, Crims is in the perfect spot, but Starix looks towards him. Starix lands the spray, and we're back into a 2-on-2.
Man, Fnatic seemed like they had this. JW, he's got to stay alive. He's right here. He's going to go down to Guardian. And this could be the end. Olofmeister almost secured the round, but now the bomb is going to go down. And this grenade won't kill Guardian. If it had been Starish down there, it would have been a one-on-one instantly. But now he's sandwiched in.
Near maximum damage taken, but Olofmeister, he's about to get caught in a crossfire because Starix is now out on the site. Olofmeister turns in time to spot this. The mad spray! What are they doing? It's just a spray battle, and somehow Starix lives with 8 HP. NaVi, take the map, even it up, and we are going the distance, Anders. We're going to the final map.
Oh, hell yes, and we're going to have to see what that map's going to be. It's a coin toss between either Dust2 or Nuke, which is obviously the important map in this context. Guys, before we do that, we're going to go to a commercial break of about 5 minutes. So don't go anywhere. We'll be back pretty soon here with the conclusion of this grand finals. What a sick game it's been. Both teams playing just very well at the moment. We'll be right back.